Good evening and welcome to St. Lawrence's College Secondary Awards Excellence Awards Night for 2023. As we begin, we ask that mobile devices switch to silent for the remainder of the ceremony. Toilets are located on level 5, and in case of an emergency, please go to the nearest exit and gather on Gare Field. We also welcome special guests tonight, including Mr. Chris Woolley, CEO of EREA Colleges Limited, and members of the College Advisory Council. Tonight, we celebrate those students who have achieved excellence in academics, sporting, and cultural pursuits. To start the ceremony, we begin with an academic procession, led by our 2023 academic prefects, who are holding our college banner and the St. Lawrence's College ceremonial mace. Ceremonial mace have been used since medieval times to denote authority on significant occasions and are used for all university graduation ceremonies. The procession comprises of curriculum, pastoral and student leaders, symbolising the significance of teachers and students working together for excellence. Please be upstanding as we welcome the academic procession. Please remain standing for the national anthem. Seated. We begin our celebration with an opening ritual led by our Dean of Identity, Mr. Paul Caulfield.
The St. Lawrence Community College acknowledges the traditional custodians of this land, the Yarraga and Turrbal peoples, who have walked and cared for this country, where life has been sustained for many thousands of years, and where our spiritual ancestors travelled the dreaming pathways. We also recognise those whose ongoing effort to protect and promote Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander cultures will have a lasting legacy for future elders and leaders. To help acknowledge country, we are joined by Yurungandi Yari students. This year, our First Nation students took on the name Yuengan Yari as part of our creating and our identity for our own First Nations community. Yanagan Yari is come from the Yarraga language, from the First Nations people here that are the traditional owners of this land on the south side of the river. Translated, this means friends. A talk. As a group, we come together as friends and we yard and share story. We present two dances tonight, a spiritual dance from North Queensland and Guardian to an Army, which was used to welcome mob from all parts of Queensland onto the Sunshine Coast for the Bunya Nut Festival. We welcome Uncle Marlon Riley and Uncle Eric Ellis to lead us.
Namely Malara Yundu, Yulamburu Yundu, give praise and respect to you all. Spirit Land, Ngāruwā, Western Yalanga Country, Cape York, Mount Carbine. Yo! Yep! Hi! That spirit creeping across the country, touching everything that's need to be renewed, and taking back to the land what's not needed on the land. This one, Gadanami, the welcome dance, also a homesick dance, longing for home. For many people, I used to travel for a long time to Bunyi, for the Bunya Mountains in Jarawa country, my grandmother's country. Yo! Angaren in the name, Daja Mobera, no garden in the name, garden in the name, Daja Mobera, no garden in the name, Daja Mobera, no garden in the name, Daja Mobera, no Gaya Mangborenga, Gaya Mangborenga. Name,
This year at St. Lawrence's College, we embrace the theme Heart of Gold as something that is alive and that burns brightly in our community. Our community is full of people who come from different backgrounds and walks of life, but it is always a place where everyone is welcome and each person is recognised for who they are. The heart of who we are is grounded in the Gospels, where each person is seen and valued for their innate dignity that is within them. As a community, each person and each story are valued. This community, where everyone can find their place through a foundation of service and care to each other and the wider community. We begin with the sign of the cross. In the name of the Father, Son, the Holy Spirit. In the founder of our school, Blessed Edmund Rice, and our patron saint, St. Lawrence O'Toole, we see the grounding for our hearts of gold. Their stories and examples help our community be a place where the dignity of each person is honoured and where everyone is able to find their place.
In 1802, Edmund Rice established his first school in New Street, Waterford. Edmund was very deliberate in the location of his school, choosing a place for his school in a wealthy area. Edmund would stand at the front of his school every morning and shake the hand of every student that walked through his gates. On one level, Edmund blessed his young people with dignity, showing them that they were worthy and were equal. On the second level, Edmund challenged the wealthy in his area who believed that the poor, especially Catholic, were not worthy. By shaking their hands in public, Edmund defied a society that believed that the poor were not worthy and showed them the value each person has. Roughly 100 years earlier, St. Lawrence O'Toole, following in the teachings of Jesus, showed his heart for compassion by seeing the dignity alive in all people. St. Lawrence's house was always open to the elderly, the poor, the widowed, and the orphans. He provided a service for the poor by feeding and housing them. He took in the orphan children and cared for them. And when his house became too full, he found people in the community who would take them in. Blessed Edmund and St. Lawrence provide a model for us. They show us what it means to see and value the dignity inside each person. Through their example, we find our heart of gold that allows each person to find their place and see the presence of Christ inside each person.
It feels like yesterday that we were in those jacaranda blue shirts, marvelling at the seniors in their white shirts, the black ties and long trousers, curious about their deep voices and strange facial hair. And then, with the blink of an eye, those seniors are now my friends, my mates, you guys, my black and gold brothers that I will be walking out of these Laurie's gates with one last time tomorrow. I was asked to share some spirited reflections with you lads about our final year at the college. Of course, I reminisce in term two, when externals were too far to stress and the vibes, to put it quite simply, were immaculate. Every Friday, team lists were released as we hung around for the chess, waiting for the fashionably late promo to be uploaded at 4 p.m, the tunnel would form and we would hear the thuds from the thirds and fifths footy steaming over after being finally dismissed on Gare Field by Dr. Herbert to join the chess LC chants. The morning of Saturday, I somehow would enjoy putting on my uniform for the sixth time that week because it meant that we were heading out to the corn. Getting out there early, seeing Mr. Wallace, hearing the whistles from the referees, parents chirping from the sideline, and especially seeing old boys return as coaches. You just knew it was going to be a good day. Saturday was honestly different gravy. As a storm was brewing, we got to gather for the football and tunnel on our mates. Then came the warm-up, our pre-game speech, followed by the blaring bagpipes as we would walk out of the change rooms, and from the Year 5 standing by our side to the old boys and footy veterans watching from the hill. And then finally looking out at the tunnel. It was all of you, the Year 12s, belting out war cries and waving our crest. That was Laurie's spirit. A community rallying around one another for the same goal. The players, the crowd, the volunteers. But the Laurie's community is so much more. It is the parent drop-offs, the first day of school photos, lunchtime shenanigans, fond memories with teachers, being role models to the younger boys, and that is the pride that we have for one another. And whilst it is sad to move on from these cherished times, that is what makes it so special. We only get this opportunity once in our lives. I couldn't have asked for a better bunch of blokes to be arm in arm with tomorrow at graduation, and it fills me with pride to know that Laurie's has a heart of gold in all of us. I thank you all for the last 8 years at this college.
This year, the college launched a number of key initiatives.
These stories remind us all that the heart of gold in this community is the people that help make it. Our hearts grow when we all play our part in building a community where each person is loved, honoured, and respected, and all our stories are held as sacred. We come as guests to each other, because when we come as guests, we listen to each other's stories and we see the dignity and face of Christ in each person. Live Jesus in our hearts.
This year, the college launched a number of key initiatives, including the Diploma of Business, German in the Middle School, and Child Version 9.0 of the National Curriculum in Years 7 to 9, one of the first schools in Australia to do so. Years 10 students also participated in the Certificate 2 in Active Volunteering, which links service learning with a vocational certificate. College staff and students also continued the enhancement of the agreed practice framework with the vision of living out the college theme, Heart of Gold. In conjunction with the St. Lawrence's Learning Framework, the agreed practice framework seeks to foster safe, positive, and productive learning environments in which students are empowered to learn and work collaboratively and autonomously to achieve excellence and, most importantly, visualize their success in the classroom. This is part of the strategic direction of the college under the inspiring leadership of college principal, Mr. Chris Ledbetter. Please welcome Mr. Chris Ledbetter to the podium for the principal's address.
Thanks very much. Mr. Chris Woolley, CEO of ERA Colleges Limited. Ms. Sharon Finn, the new Chief Financial Officer of ERA Colleges and former staff member. Members of the St. Lawrence's College Advisory Council, including Tanya Hansen, the Chair of the Laurie's Community Committee. Members of the LCC, staff, parents, caregivers and friends of the college. On Sunday, I sat down to write this address. And I'll say I found it somewhat difficult. And my normal pattern is to list all the events through the years, go through my newsletters, and look at what I'd speak about as a theme. I found it somewhat superficial. Although proud of the efforts of our students, our staff and our community, and the success that they had, my heart was somewhat heavy. My reflections move to the people who make up the community, in particular those we've lost. Earlier this year, a well-known past student, passionate Laurie's man and great community contributor, Anthony Retiri, passed away from cancer. The funeral at Camp Hill was outstanding. In December of last year, our community was asked by the government to support the funeral of Constable Matthew Arnold, who was tragically murdered at a property near Weambilla, along with Constable Rachel McCrow. Matthew was a former student from the class of 2013. The scars of this episode still affect many of us within the community today. On Thursday, October 12 at 9:15 a.m, Year 9 Duig student Addison Miller, or Addy, passed away following a courageous battle with leukaemia. Addison's passing was felt most strongly by us all, but particularly Year 9 Duig. Mr. Richard King, head of Duig, has been superb in his efforts to support Addison, Darren, Mei Ling and Rihanna, as well as the students in his house. Indeed, Mr. King and I had the privilege to visit Addison shortly following his passing. At his bedside were family, mum, dad, grandparents, his sister, a social worker, and Addison's oncologist arrived a short time after, Dr. D'Ambrosis. He then sent me this email. I just wanted to reach out regarding one of your students currently under my care at the Children's Hospital, Addison Miller. I've had the privilege of being Addison's paediatric oncologist since 2022. This is obviously an extremely difficult time for Addy and his family and your community as well, and I'm thinking of you all. I wanted to let you know of a conversation I had with Addison recently, as I think it's important that you all realise how important Laurie's has been to Addy throughout this journey, and what a huge part of his life you've all been. Addison was in the depths of one of his prolonged ICU admissions when I mentioned to him that I heard that Laurie's open day had been on. His face immediately lit up, as it always does when Laurie's is mentioned, particularly when I asked him if he thought it was a good place to send young boys or young men. I've since found out Dr. David has two sons. His answer was yes. They don't just care about your grades or how good you are at sports there. Well, care about both of those, but we'll go on to the next point. They aim to create kind men in a time when there aren't enough of those around. What struck me as pretty extraordinary for an insight of a critically unwell 14-year-old boy who'd been through too much already. As I'm certain you already know, Addison is a uniquely special boy who has touched many of us over at the Children's Hospital. And along with the work of Darren and Mei Ling, he's an absolute credit to the work you are doing at SLC as well. Thinking of you all, Dr. David D'Ambrosis, and this title is exceptional, Paediatric Oncologist and Stem Cell Transplant Physician, Queensland's Children's Hospital. So I perhaps changed tact when I was looking at what I might speak about. The line that struck me, they aim to create kind men in a time when there aren't enough of those around. This was a lad who topped his maths and science class while in hospital. And he was worried going through chemo that he might have to repeat because he was falling behind. There was never a chance that he would fall behind. So as I read Dr. D'Ambrosis' email, it became clear that Catholic education, and that in the Edmund Rice tradition, is an education that liberates and assists young people to be good, and good people. Each school needs to equip young people for life after school. Students need options for the future, and they should develop skills and knowledge to assist them in becoming effective citizens. Here I quote from the Congregation of Catholic Education from Rome. That's not normal for me, by the way. In the face of contemporary challenges echoing the Second Vatican Council, Pope Francis recognises the central value of education. It is a wide-ranging pastoral project for a church that goes forth, standing by people at every step of the way, making her presence felt in education, which teaches critical thinking and encourages the development of mature moral values. So what that said to me is there are a lot of great schools that get a lot of good outcomes. And if NAPLAN's your sole reason for running a school, so be it. If winning first premierships is your sole reason for running a school, so be it. If academics results are the only reason for running your school, so be it. We think our mission is far greater than that. A Catholic education in the Edmund Rice tradition engages the hearts of our people. Perhaps our theme, Heart of Gold, or Find Your Heart of Gold, is most apt here. Anthony Retiri, Matthew Arnold, and Addison Miller have touched our lives. Yet it is my hope that Laurie's has also touched theirs. Challenging our young people to do the best they can while focusing on the well-being of others is what we aspire to do. In this regard, I need to commend our extraordinary staff who commit to the education and the mission of educating young men daily. This year, John Roberts has retired after 32 years of service to the college, and by his own admission, he's had a great time at the same time. Noel Toohey will retire after 41 years of service to the college. Mr. Peter Foster, a doyen of the art department, has been here for 37 years and retires as well. Jeanette Partington leaves us after 30 years at a point next year following leave. And Basil Ranieri, or Uncle Baz as the boys sometimes call him, retires after 23 years of working in our primary student. I commend the work of all of these people. We also farewell Miss Sharon Finn, who was our business manager, and then her title changed, which meant business manager with a new name, and she moved to the role of CFO at EREA College Limited. I'd ask our head of middle school, Miss Vanessa Bell, to come forth, and we know Sharon hates the limelight, and her eyes aren't great, so she wouldn't get up the steps anyway. And I'd ask Vanessa Bell, head of middle school, to do this presentation. Ladies and gentlemen, if you could acclaim Sharon. Mr. Eddie Wallace retired earlier in the year as well, and I'm delighted that he's now the new AOC Executive Officer, and he was here for 17 years in the really easy job of Head of Sport. Both have made an extraordinary contribution to the lives of our young people. We also farewell some long-standing staff members in Dr. Chris Boredom, Mr. Matthew Wilson and Mr. Joel Glasbrook. We wish all staff moving on all the best and thank them for the work. Each year, I award one or two staff with the Principal's Award for Service. I'm going to ask Mr. Larry to assist with this. In this regard, the first recipient is a teaching staff member, and I wish to affirm the head of Sion House, Mr. Lachlan Hesusius, for his outstanding contribution to the growth and development of many students. As a past student, Lachlan understands the Laurie's difference. If you could join me in congratulating Lachlan Hesusius. Thank you. I also wish to congratulate a support and non-teaching staff member who is our international student coordinator, and she was our Queensland Independent Secondary Schools Rugby League co-convener. She has been outstanding over the course of her time here and did a great deal of work with the international students, particularly in the COVID epidemic when they couldn't go home or had to return home, never to come to our shores again. Desley Armitage has been fantastic looking after the needs of young people, working with staff and organising a very difficult event which is called Confro. She assisted Eddie Wallace in the carnival, which had 52 boys and 12 girls team held in the June-July holidays. So I'd ask Miss Desley Armitage to please come forward. As much of this address has been mission-based, I do need to congratulate some of the following people. Tonight we have Mr. Chris Woolley here. He's the inaugural CEO of EREA Colleges Limited. Now, I'm not really sure what that means, and nor is he, but he's doing the job anyway. Now, Chris's job comprises managing the Queensland schools, the Western Australian schools, the South Australian schools, and two other places in ACT and Tassie. And that's 18 colleges across the country. I also affirm two students who were the Ducks last year, Adam Browse and Cameron Griffiths, who achieved an ATAR of 99.90. And generally, they get a call from someone in the office with the other award winners to come in. And I forgot that most of them are 18 now. So they didn't have much sleep, a few of those boys, when they came in during the December break to receive the announcement that they were the joint Ducks holders. I also want to affirm Mackenzie Douglas, Knightley Patterson and Sam Underwood, who have led the seniors this year with passion and pride. They've been outstanding. I acknowledge the new student leaders next year of Gianluca Josi, Harry Frost and Tate Kwolaszewski. I must thank the leadership team, Ben Larry, Liam Herbert, David Knight, Vanessa Bell, Kirsten Wardrop, Cameron Wigan, Paul Caulfield and Sharon Finn. But a special thank you to Nick Leskey and Michelle Jide, who have supported us during Sharon's secondment to EREA Colleges. We're all most proud of our young people and I congratulate all award winners here tonight. The group I particularly congratulate are those who've overcome significant difficulty to achieve great results. I also affirm those boys who aren't receiving awards tonight, because sometimes a C plus is excellent. And I remember seeing one of our students sit there every afternoon at the library, work the house down to get a C plus. So sometimes excellence is personal, whatever that might look like. Next year, we hope to begin stage one of the master plan, should Mr. Woolley and Ms. Finn approve a new loan application. But I'm sure with flowers and that affirmation, there will be no issue. That's following the completion of the Hogan Deck, which is happening as we speak. We hope that will make all the difference to the teaching and learning at this school, but I always understand you can have mediocre buildings and great teaching and learning, and great buildings and poor teaching and learning. We need to invest in our people. We'll unveil a new three-year strategic plan. If you want to go to sleep at night, just read it. It's not overly riveting unless you look at what the operational activities will be. For me, they are most exciting. That will be presented to EREA colleges at the end of this year for release in the new year. One of our chief aims is to continue with our partnerships. such as the QUT Fellowship Program for young teachers and beginning teachers, the Man City Football School, many of our vet programs, as well as things like Coding Club, Drone Club, etc. St Lawrence is currently experiencing strong enrolment pressure with a waiting list in Year 5 and 7. For me, that's a good thing, but I'm pretty soft with that stuff, so I find it really hard to turn people away. Unfortunately, we've had to do that. Sometimes the message to enrol on time and get things in on time doesn't go across, and it's a really difficult conversation with some parents who aren't able to have enrolment. So intake in Year 7 next year will be 290, and in Year 5, 170. The college population will grow to over 2,000. I was going to say 2,000 odd, but they're not all odd. Parents, perhaps other people, other parents, want their sons to become kind men when there's not enough of those around. God bless you all.
Religion at St. Lawrence's College explores the personal, relational, and spiritual perspectives of the human experience. Students investigate religious traditions, how religion has influenced people's lives, and the role and function of religion and ethics in society. Joining College Principal, Mr. Chris Ledbetter, to present the Religion Faculty Awards, please welcome to the stage the Head of Religion, Ms. Leonie Mount, and the Assistant Head of Religion, Ms. Lisa Preby.
Please hold your applause until the end. The Religion Award winners for 2023 are Year 7, Felix Hardy. And Angus Linster. Year 8, Philosophy and Reason, James Gormley. Year 8, Religion, Jonathan Isilow. Year 9, Philosophy and Reason, Oliver Stephen, absent. Year 9, Religion, Toby Mann and Archibald Simmons. Year 10, Philosophy and Reason, McKinnon Moffat. Year 10, Religion, Ethan Connolly. Year 10, Religion and Ethics, Flynn Byram. Year 10, Study of Religion, Morgan Oiso. Year 11, Philosophy and Reason, Patrick Woolley. Year 11, Religion and Ethics, Toby Parker. Year 11, Study of Religion, Daniel O'Neill, absent. Year 12, Philosophy and Reason, Jared Komen. Year 12, Religion and Ethics, Billy Nielsen. Year 12, Study of Religion, Tonga Pohila and James O'Sullivan. Please congratulate the Religion Faculty Academic winners for 2023.
Students in the Humanities Faculty develop the ability to question, think critically, solve problems, communicate effectively, make decisions, and adapt to change. Please welcome to the stage the Head of Humanities, Ms. Natalie Kilburn, to announce the awards.
Please hold your applause until the end. The Humanities Award winners for 2023 are Year 7 Humanities, Liam Pippia. Year 8 Humanities, Matthew O'Sullivan. Year 9 Geography, Toby Mann. Year 9 History, Josiah Spence. Year 10 Accelerated Geography, Morgan Oiso. Year 10 Accelerated Modern History, Lloyd Oliver. Year 10 Ancient History, McKinnon Moffat. Year 10 Geography, Cairo Lynch. Year 10 Modern History, Jake Foreman. Year 11, Accelerated Ancient History, Nathan Wicks. Year 11, Accelerated Geography, Erin O'Brien. Year 11, Accelerated Modern History, Patrick Woolley. Year 11, Ancient History, Evan Chamberlain. Year 11, Geography, Cooper Frangie. Year 11, Modern History, Luca Pinoso. Year 12, Ancient History, Dimitri Kong. Year 12, Geography, Jack Montague. Year 12, Modern History, Max Rosberg. Please congratulate the Humanities Faculty Award winners for 2023.
Physical education provides students with knowledge, understanding, and skills to explore and enhance their own and others' health and physical activity in diverse and changing contexts. Joining College Principal Mr. Chris Ledbetter to present the Health and Physical Education Faculty Awards, please welcome to the stage the Head of Health and Physical Education, Mr. Josh Beattie, and announcing the awards, the Assistant Head of Health and Physical Education, Ms. Christy Carroll.
Please hold your applause until the end. The Physical Education Award winners for 2023 are Year 7 Health and Physical Education, Mikhail Mendes. Year 8 Health and Physical Education, Stephen Carey. Year 9 Health and Physical Education, Archibald Simmons. Year 10 Certificate 2 Sport and Recreation, Aidan Lamont. Year 10 Physical Education, Andrew Stamp. Year 10 Sport and Recreation, Luke Thompson. Year 11 Certificate 3 Fitness, James Watson. Year 11 Physical Education, Samuel Geary. Year 11 Sport and Recreation, Patrick Churchwood. Year 12 Certificate 3 Fitness, Benjamin Taylor. Year 12 Physical Education, Jaden McCauley. Year 12 Physical Education, Benjamin Maynard. Year 12 Sport and Recreation, Miles Legoulin. And Year 12 Sport and Recreation, Josh Robertson. Please congratulate the Health and Physical Education Faculty Academic Award winners.
Science provides opportunities for students to develop an understanding of important science concepts and processes, as well as the practices used to develop scientific knowledge, particularly through scientific inquiry. Joining College Principal Mr. Chris Ledbetter to present the Science Faculty Awards, please welcome to the stage the Head of Science, Mr. Scott Walter, and the Head of House, Ms. Crystal Kennedy.
Please hold your applause until the end. The Science Award winners for 2023 are Year 7 Science, Nicholas Thorpe. Year 8 Science, Matthew O'Sullivan. Year 9 Science, Toby Mann. Year 10 Applied Science, Maxwell Graham. Year 10 Biology, Huxley Stevenson. Year 10 Chemistry, Ethan Connolly. Year 10 Physics, Joji Taya Jones. Year 10 Psychology, Simeon Jeremijenko. Year 11 Biology, Marco Fomorka. Year 11 Chemistry and Year 11 Physics, Mitchell West. Year 11 Physics, Alexander Brimblecombe. Year 11 Psychology, Harvey Lowe. Year 12 Biology, Year 12 Chemistry, and Year 12 Physics, Miguel Galarian. Year 12 Psychology, Ryan Moore. Please congratulate the Science Faculty Academic Award winners for 2023.
Sport allows for individual and collective excellence. This year, all who have engaged in this aspect of school life have enhanced our sporting history and added a new chapter to our sporting tradition across all sports that are offered. Joining College Principal, Mr. Chris Ledbetter, to present the Trimester 1 Sport Awards, please welcome to the stage the Head of Sport, Mr. Patrick Byron, the Director of AFL, Mr. Sam Wiltshire, the Director of Cricket, Mr. Josh Ferguson, the Director of Swimming, Mr. Danny O'Sullivan, and the Director of Volleyball, Mr. Anthony Bird.
Please hold your applause until the end. The AFL awards for 2023 are Year 7 Trophy, Max Bush. Year 8 Trophy, Harrison Taylor. Junior AFL Year 9-10 Award, Charles Taylor. First 18 Best and Fairest, William Munro. First 18, Most Improved, Riley Clark. And the first 18 AFL medal, Jackson Parker.
The Cricket Awards for 2023 are Mrs. Ruby Cusack Memorial Trophy for Year 7-11, Angus Jones-Shepherd. Year 8-11 Trophy, Oscar Santos. Tom Lehman Trophy for Year 9-11, Kaelin Reynolds. Year 10-11 Trophy, Nate Bainbrig. First 11 Best All-Rounder, Xavier Santos. Paul Reynolds Trophy for First 11 Best Batsman, Thomas Stenhouse. And Stephen Plummer Trophy for First 11 Best Bowler, Mackenzie Douglas.
The Swimming Awards for 2023 are the Bill Cusack Memorial Trophy for Under 12 Champion, William Wowar. Under 13 champion, William Mann. Under 14 champion, Javier Foster. Under 15 champion, Toby Mann. Under 16 champion, Sean Miranda. Open champion, Oliver Cook. And the Senior Encouragement Trophy Kobe Clark.
The Volleyball Awards for 2023 are the Year 7 6 Trophy, Preston Drew. The Year 8 6 Trophy, Stephen Carey. The Year 9 6 Trophy, Benjamin Trenow. The Year 10 6 Trophy, Atticus Lynch. The Year 11 6 Trophy, Chase Ford. The Peter Ward Memorial Trophy for the first six, James Kidd. And the Senior Encouragement Award for Thomas Jago. Please congratulate the AFL cricket, swimming and volleyball champions for 2023.
Visual and performing arts develop critical and creative thinking skills that allow students to make sense of the world around them. Students in the visual and performing arts faculty are encouraged to explore their creativity, self-expression, and build confidence as innovators and global thinkers. Joining College Principal Mr. Chris Ledbetter to present the Visual and Performing Arts Faculty Awards, please welcome to the stage the Head of Visual and Performing Arts, Ms. Maria Mavritsky, and the Assistant Heads of Faculty of Drama, Ms. Rebecca Dorge, Film, Television and New Media, Mr. Sam Clark, Music, Mr. Julian Leininger, and Art, Mr. Peter Foster.
And please hold your applause until the end. The Drama Award winners for 2023 are Year 8 Drama, Benjamin Somerville. Year 9 Drama, Jake Mengelakis. Year 10 Drama, Eric Dwyer. Year 11 Drama and Year 11 Arts in Practice, Jaden Chews, and Year 12 Drama and Year 12 Visual Art, Tonga Puhilia.
The Film, Television and New Media Award winners are Year 8 Media, David Griffiths, absent. Year 9 Media, Archibald Simmons. Year 10, Film, Television and New Media, Atticus Lynch. Year 11, Film, Television and New Media, Joshua Fisher. And Year 12, Film, Television and New Media, Cosmas Forgius.
The Music Award winners are Year 8 Music and Year 8 Art, Jasper Griffiths. Year 9 Music, Ahn Hun. Year 9 Music, Moses Dixon. Year 10 Music, Simeon Jeremijenko. Year 10 Music, Anton Ruckel-Erbs. Year 11 Music, Marco Famorca. Year 12 Music, James Kidd. Year 12 Music Extension, Joshua Sefton.
The Visual Art Award winners for 2023 are Year 7 Arts Award, Angus Jones Shepherd. Year 7 Arts Award, Mikhail Mendes. Year 9 Art, Michael Woolley. Year 10, Arts and Practice, Gerson Ianella. Year 10, Visual Art, McKinnon Moffat. Year 11, Visual Art, Harvey Lowe. Year 12, Arts and Practice, Noah van der Weyer. Please congratulate the Visual and Performing Arts Faculty Academic Award winners.
Studying technologies allows students to generate, develop, and evaluate ideas, as well as design, produce, and evaluate products, services, and environments in a range of technology contexts in home, community, and global settings. Joining College Principal, Mr. Chris Ledbetter, to present the Technologies Awards, please welcome to the stage the Head of Technologies, Mr. Danny O'Sullivan, and the Assistant Heads of Faculty, Mr. James Sherry, Mr. Mark Wachner, and Mr. Thomas Bryden.
Please hold your applause until the end. The Engineering and Industrial Technology Award winners are Year 7 Industrial Technology, Finbar Fitzgibbon. Year 8 Engineering Industrial Technology, Benjamin Dillon. Year 10 Engineering and Year 10 Certificate 3 Engineering Technical CAD, Lachlan Witham. Year 10 Certificate 3 Engineering Technical CAD, Alfred Tarabay. Year 10 Vocational Trade Studies A, Thomas Ahern. Year 10 Vocational Trade Studies B, Luke Robertson. Year 11 QUT Engineering Award, Nish Yolanda. Year 11 Certificate 1 in Construction, Declan Layton. Year 11 Certificate 2 Engineering Technical CAD, Liam Hughes. Year 11 Certificate 2 in Electro Technology and Engineering Pathways, Nicholas Estella. Year 11 Furnishing Studies, Andrew Stanford. Year 12 QUT Engineering Award, Kai Klesanen. Year 12 Certificate 1 Construction, Blake Parmenta. Year 12 Certificate 2 Electro Technology, Jack Callan. Year 12 Certificate 3 Engineering Technical CAD, Darcy Brown. Year 12 Certificate 2 Engineering Pathways, Callan Sazolka. Year 12 Furnishing Skills, Lachlan Sutton.
The Information Technology Award winners are Year 8 Information Technology, Matthew O'Sullivan. Year 9 Information Technology, Matthias Alpatti. Year 10 Digital Solutions, Jack Reed. Year 11 Digital Solutions, Zenon Lee. Year 12 Digital Solutions, Oliver Thornthwaite. The Graphics and Design Award winners are Year 8 Graphics and Design, Ivan Wong. Year 9 Graphics and Design, Darshanik Panaselvan. Year 10 Design, Blaise Buchan. Year 11 QUT Design Award, Noah Fitzpatrick. And Year 12 QUT Design Award, Tobias Percy. Please congratulate the Technologies Faculty Academic Award winners for 2023.
Tonight, the College Symphony Orchestra, Brotherhood, Little Brotherhood, and Guitar Orchestra join forces to present a combined performance of Baba Yetu. Baba Yetu is a Swahili setting of the Lord's Prayer, originally commissioned as the theme song for the video game Civilization IV. It was composed by Christopher Tin and arranged especially for our musicians by Laurie's string teacher, Mr. Ben Adkins. Please welcome the music ensembles and the conductor, Mr. Ross Capern.
Yeah.
again, please congratulate the SLC Symphony Orchestra for this outstanding performance.
Alongside striving for excellence in their academic pursuits, Laurie students are called to explore their diverse gifts and talents in the wide range of cultural, musical, social, spiritual, and service learning aspects of college life. These activities provide for the growth of the whole person by developing individual skills, teamwork, leadership, mateship, understanding and self-discipline in an atmosphere of fun and enjoyment. Joining College Principal Mr. Chris Ledbetter to present the cultural awards, please welcome to the stage Miss Michelle Guide, Dean of Finance, and Mr. Nick Leschke, Dean of Business Operations and Information Technology. To announce the awards, we welcome Mr. Paul Caulfield, Dean of Identity and Community.
Please hold your applause until the end. The cultural award winners for 2023 are Principal's Art Acquisition Award, Tonga Puhila; Senior Photographic Digital Art Awards, Nicholas Figliano; Senior Three Dimensional Art Award, Jared Chamberlain; Senior Two Dimensional Art Award, Cosmos Vorgis; Middle School Three Dimensional Art Award and Debating, Year Seven, Mikhail Mendes; Middle School Two Dimensional Art Award, Michael Woolley; Debating Senior Award, Cruz Bunting; Debating Year 11, Patrick Woolley; Debating Year 10, Darcy Bryan; Debating Year 9, Mason Wills; Debating Year 8, Matthew O'Sullivan. Joel Hamilton Memorial Award for Outstanding Contribution to Drama, James Sanderlands. Richard Potts Memorial Prize for Outstanding Contribution to Music, Kieran Van Acker. Lenore Bateman Award for Music Composition, Hugo Barrett. George Plunkett Award for Music Performance, Miles LeGoulin. Kath Stoodley Award for Music Analysis, Marcus Shepherd. Emergency Services Cadet of the Year, Ellis Connell. Faith in Action Award, Year 11, Gianluca Josi. Year 10 Future Innovator Award, McKinnon Moffat. The Australian Defence Force Long Tan Youth Leadership and Teamwork Award, Ethan Connolly. Please congratulate the Cultural Award winners for 2023.
The business subject area provides opportunities for students to develop business knowledge and skills to contribute meaningfully to society, the workforce, and the marketplace. Languages provide students with the opportunity to learn a new language and develop appreciation for diverse cultures. Formal language subjects at St. Lawrence's College are Chinese and German. Joining College Principal Mr. Chris Ledbetter to present the Business and Languages Awards, please welcome to the stage the Head of Business and Languages, Ms. Alana Bailey, and the Assistant Head of Faculty, Ms. Sophia Lynch.
Please hold your applause to the end. Year 8 Business Studies, Matthew O'Sullivan. Year 9 Business Studies, Lewis Head. Year 9 Business Studies, Isaac Economides. Year 10 Accounting, Benjamin Stahlmann. Year 10 Business, Alexander Saramento. Year 10 Business Communication, Cooper Brown. Year 10 Economics, Luca Ellero. Year 10 Economics, Will Threadingham. Year 10 Legal Studies, Oscar Clancy. Year 11 Accounting, Johan Naidu. Year 11 Business, Chase Ford. Year 11 Certificate 3 in Business, Oscar Love. Year 11 Economics, Alexander Brimblecombe. Year 11 Legal Studies, Gianluca Josi. Year 12 Accounting, James Goodyear. Year 12 Business, Jaden McCauley. Year 12 Certificate 3 in Business, Bailey Lowe. Year 12 Economics, James O'Sullivan. Year 12 Legal Studies, Cruz Bunting. The Language Award winners are Year 7 Chinese, Mikkel Mendes. Year 7 German, Parker Yeo. Year 8 Chinese, Andrew Young. Year 8 German, James Gormley. Year 9 Chinese, Joseph Bock. Year 10 Chinese, Ethan Conley. Year 11 Chinese, Xu Jie Wang. Year 12 Chinese and the Kevin Rudd Foreign Language Award, Damon Wang. Please congratulate the Business and Language Award winners for 2023.
Joining College Principal, Mr. Chris Ledbetter, to present the Trimester 2 Sport Awards, please welcome to the stage the Head of Sport, Mr. Patrick Byron, the Director of Chess, Ms. Sophia Lynch, the Director of Cross Country, Ms. Charlotte Wilson, the Director of Football, Mr. Sam Wiltshire, and the Director of Rugby, Mr. Pat Richards.
Please hold your applause to the end. The Chess Awards for 2023 are... Secondary Champion and the AIC Senior Chess Award goes to Kevin Reid. AIC Intermediate Chess Award goes to Alexander Green.
The Cross Country Awards for 2023 are Under 12 Champion, Christian Brew Graves. Under 13 Champion, Callum Johns. Under 14 Champion, Jasper Grickas. Under 15 champion, Oscar McKean, who is absent. Under 16 champion, Patrick Churchwood. The Hal Rice Trophy for Open champion, Jack Coomber. The Renouf Brothers Trophy for most team-spirited athlete, Archibald Simmons and Mitchell Benham.
The Football Awards for 2023 are Year 7 Trophy, Lucas Krennic. Year 8 Trophy, Oscar Santos and Matthew Lutz. Year 9 Trophy, Jules Pinozzo. Year 10 Trophy, Luca Ellero. Best and fairest first 11 player of the season, Nadir Nauri. Most promising first 11 player, Connor Economides. And most improved first 11 player, Liam Baxter.
The Rugby Awards for 2023, Brother John Hanson Trophy for Year 7, Sam Madden. Year 8, 15 Trophy, Jaden Malemi. Year 9 15 Trophy, Digby Cale. The Bob Ray Trophy for Year 10 15, Liam O'Callaghan. First 15 Best Back, Jack Toot. First 15 Best Forward, Bailey Catelli. Most Improved First 15 Player, Oscar Hunter. Best and Fairest First 15 Player of the Season, Finn Mackay. Please congratulate the Chess, Cross Country, Football and Rugby Champions for 2023.
The Brotherhood has had an exciting year, receiving a Gold Award at the Catholic Colleges Music Festival and performing at the nationally acclaimed PEMAWAY National Male Voice Festival at QPAC. Students in this group are drawn from years 10 to 12 and come together each week to share the joy of singing. Tonight they will perform a piece of original Australian choral music written by Mr. William Brown and with words by Banjo Patterson, entitled As Long As Your Eyes Are Blue. This will be followed by the 1959 smash hit Dream Lover, written and recorded by the legendary Bobby Darin.
When the charms of you sleep and dream again. That's the only thing to do till my lover's dreams come true. Because I want a girl to call, to call my own.
My own.
I want a dream lover so I don't have to dream alone.
Please congratulate the Brotherhood for their performance.
English develops students' reading, listening, speaking, and writing skills to equip them to become thoughtful communicators and careful questioners in an increasingly globalised and complex world. Joining College Principal, Mr. Chris Ledbetter, to present the English Awards, please welcome to the stage the Head of English, Mr. Neil Smith, and the Assistant Head of English, Ms. Donna Braithwaite.
The English Award winners for 2023 are Year 7 English, Max Bush. Year 7 English Foundation, Isaac Dowley. Year 8 English, Matthew O'Sullivan. Year 8 English Foundation, Oren Utia. Year 9 English, Michael Woolley. Year 9 English Foundation, Kaylin Reynolds. Year 10 English, Darcy Bryan. Year 10 English as an additional language, Anlin So. Year 10 Essential English, Harry Raven. Year 10 Literature, Anton Raggle Erbs. Year 11 English, Gianluca Josi. Year 11 English as an additional language, Yamato Fukushi. Year 11 Essential English, Declan Stuart McGrath. Year 11 Literature, Alastair Greensill. Year 12 English, Miguel Galarian. Year 12 English as an additional language, Chris Huang. Year 12 English Extension, Cruz Bunting. Year 12 Essential English, Jack Chute. And Year 12 Literature, Joshua Sefton. Please congratulate the English Academic Award winners for 2023.
Mathematics underpins many of the emerging 21st century skills. In a world that is increasingly driven by data analysis and technology networks, it should be no surprise that mathematics is regarded as a key component of a successful education. Joining College Principal Mr. Chris Ledbetter to present the Mathematics Awards, please welcome to the stage the Head of Mathematics, Mr. Ben Litchfield, and the Assistant Head of Mathematics, Ms. Charlotte Wilson.
Please hold your applause until the end. Year 7 Mathematics, Angus Jones-Shepherd and Daniel Chadburn. Year 7 Mathematics Extension, Frederick Patola. Year 8 Mathematics, James Gormley. Year 8 Mathematics Extension, Matthew O'Sullivan. Year 8 Mathematics Foundation, Michael Clark. Year 9 Mathematics, Ryan Matapat. Year 9 Mathematics Extension, Mateus Alpati. Year 9 Mathematics Foundation, Dominique West, who is absent. Year 10 Essential Mathematics, Maxwell Graham. Year 10 General Mathematics, Aidan Lamont. Year 10 Mathematical Methods, Alexander Saramento. Year 10 Mathematical Methods Accelerated and Year 10 Specialist Mathematics, Finn Todeman. Year 11 Essential Mathematics, Will Crofts. Year 11 General Mathematics, James Watson. Year 11 Mathematical Methods, Archie Jones Shepherd. Year 11 Mathematical Methods Accelerated, Will Potter. Year 11 Specialist Mathematics, Mitchell West. Year 12 Essential Mathematics, Sam Gettinat, who is absent. Year 12 General Mathematics, Anthony Jung. Year 12 Mathematical Methods, Zach Lamarca. Year 12 Specialist Mathematics, Miguel Galarian. Please congratulate the Mathematics Academic Award winners for 2023.
Joining College Principal, Mr. Chris Ledbetter, to present the Trimester 3 Sport Awards. Please welcome to the stage the Head of Sport, Mr. Patrick Byron, the Director of Basketball, Mr. Brett Holzheimer, the Director of Rugby League, Mr. John Butterworth, the Director of Tennis, Mr. Sam Wiltshire, and the Assistant Head of Sport, Mr. Pat Richards.
Please hold your applause until the end. The Basketball Awards for 2023 are... Year 7 Trophy, Carlin Thompson. Year 8 Trophy, Jade A. Fletcher and Adam Habchi. Year 9 Trophy, Benjamin Treno. Year 10 Trophy, Hayden Berman. First 5 Most Improved, Sam Geary. Year 11 trophy and Senior Encouragement Trophy, Nick Estella. And the David Graham Trophy for Best First Five Player, Mitchell Treno.
The Rugby League Awards for 2023 are... Year 7, Best and Fairest, Sam Madden. Year 8, Harrison Taylor. Year 9, Kaelin Mackay. Year 10, Liam O'Callaghan. The First 13, Best Forward, Ned Bradley. First 13, Best Back, Finn Mackay. And the First 13, Best and Fairest, Jack Tute.
The Tennis Awards for 2023 are Year 7 Champion, Maddox Nguyen, who is absent tonight. Year 8 Champion, Van Thomas Greer. Year 9 Champion, Henri O'Malley Kramer, who is also absent tonight. Year 11 champion, Fergus Gallagher. And year 10 champion and open champion, Ethan Connolly.
The Track and Field Awards for 2023 are Senior Encouragement Trophy, Cameron Evetts. Years champion, Jake Arnold. 13 years champion, Callum Johns. 14 years champion, Remy Laporte. Fifteen years champion, Oscar McKean, absent. 16 years champion, Terrell Thorne. Open champion, Jack Kumba. Also open champion, Nathan Taverner. Please congratulate the basketball, rugby league, tennis, and track and field award winners for 2023.
Please welcome Mackenzie Douglas to the stage to present the college captain's address.
The Laurier's Way. After countless hours of brainstorming, we concluded that this was to be the motto for the year 2023. We have not known the power to this phrase, but now looking back on the journey of 2023, we use this phrase in almost every facet of college life. Everyone who has sat through a whole school assembly this past year has heard the spiel of the meaning of this motto. But for those who haven't, I've decided to share it tonight. The Laurier's Way embodies the meaning to be a true Laurier's gentleman, to venture through your schooling journey on your own path. Inclusivity, brotherhood, accountability, authenticity, DWIZARD, integrity, affirming, engagement, and passion are the core values that we hold close to our hearts. These are the values that make up the Laurier's Way. As a 2023 senior cohort, our mission was to spread these values as far and as wide as we could, ensuring we left a mark on the college. Although we embark on our journeys down the Laurier's Way at similar stages with hundreds of brothers in our cohorts, we are all different. We may experience hardships at different stages, we may experience success at different stages, and we may have different interests to our peers. We acknowledge this. In fact, we completely understand this. Yet whilst we have our differences, there is comfort in knowing that we are all connected. Along our Laurier's Way, we have guardrails, our teachers, our friends, our family, who ensure we do not veer off the side of a 1,000-foot mountain. This also means the student themselves are guardrails for other students, fostering a uniting and uplifting culture in which everyone is connected. Whatever the interest, there is a place for everyone on this great hill, and that is the true embodiment of the Laurier's Way. As we come together tonight in celebration of so many great successes, I think it is important to note the hard work that often goes unnoticed to achieve these. Epictetus once said, "Progress is not achieved by luck or by accident, but by working on yourself daily." The recipients who sit before us this evening embody this so greatly. No one becomes a duck of geography by luck or by accident, nor does anybody excel in co-curricular activity by luck or by accident. Instead, they work hard for it. Hours and hours must be dedicated towards perfecting the craft, and even once the craft is perfected, there is still a journey to go. It is then time to execute what they have perfected, and only once they have executed, they can put themselves closer to achieving the desired outcome. It is safe to say that every recipient tonight has executed. They first dedicated themselves to reaching their personal best and then executed what they had worked so hard for. And now, it is time to be proud of what they have accomplished. I congratulate every award recipient on reaching your personal best. And it must also be noted the role that those around the recipients played. On behalf of all the students tonight, I'd like to thank the parents and guardians. I'd like to thank the teachers. And finally, I'd like to thank the friends. You are all our guardrails. And especially as teenagers, your support is often needed to ensure we don't veer off that 1,000-foot mountain. Much of the success tonight comes down to that. And so I believe we owe everyone who we have in our corner a round of applause.
St. Lawrence's College Big Band 1, conducted by Mr. Rob Anders, is composed of talented and dedicated young musicians who have achieved remarkable success by rehearsing twice a week throughout the year. Earlier this year, they participated in workshops with internationally acclaimed musicians Jackie Cooper and John Morrison, who provided them with valuable insights and feedback. They also performed notably at the Queensland Catholic Music Festival this year and were recipients of a Gold Award for their outstanding performance. Tonight they will perform two numbers. The first, Hunting Wabbits, is a humorous and energetic piece written by Gordon Goodwin to depict the hunt and chase of a wascally wabbit. It features the saxophone and trombone sections and solo by Miles Leguon on soprano saxophone. The second, It's Not Unusual, is a classic song by Tom Jones, sung tonight by Mitchell Wilson with a big band backing. The song also features a cameo solo by Marcus Shepherd on lead trombone. Please give a warm round of applause to the St. Lawrence's College Big Band 1.
Thank you. The saxophone section, ladies and gentlemen, and the trombones, and Miles. We're going to ask Mitchell Wilson to come on stage. Come on, Mitchell. You can do your Tom Jones thing for us.
Thank you very much.
Not unusual to be loved by anyone. It's not unusual to have fun with anyone. But if I ever find that you've changed at any time, it's not unusual to see me cry. I wanna die. It's not unusual to go out at any time. When I see you out and about, it's such a crime. If you should ever wanna be loved by anyone, it's not unusual, it happens every day. No matter what you say, you'll find it happens all the time. Love will never do what you want it to. Why can't this crazy love be mine? Changed at any time. It's not unusual to find out I'm in love with you. Not unusual, yeah!
Mitch Wilson, ladies and gentlemen. And Big Band One.
The Year Level Ducks Award is presented to the student in each year level who has achieved the highest academic score across all subjects. The Dedication and Merit Awards are presented to those students who have achieved excellent results across all subjects and who have displayed a diligent commitment to their studies throughout the year. Joining College Principal Mr. Chris Ledbetter to present the Dedication and Merit and Ducks Awards for Middle School, please welcome to the stage the Dean of Middle School, Ms. Vanessa Bell, and the Head of Middle School Teaching and Learning, Ms. Sophia Controtis.
Please hold your applause until the end. The Year 7 Dedication and Merit Awards go to Angus Jones Shepherd, Parker Yeo, and Nicholas Thorpe. The 2023 Ducks of Year 7 is awarded to Mikhail Mendes and Liam Pippier. Please congratulate our Year 7 award winners. The Year 8 Dedication and Merit goes to James Gormley, Andrew Young, and Lachlan Manning. The 2023 Pat O'Neill Prize for the Ducks of Year 8 is awarded to Matthew O'Sullivan. Please again congratulate our Year 8 Dedication of Merit and Ducks recipients. The Year 9 Dedication and Merit Awards go to Archibald Simmons, Toby Mann, and Matthias Alpatti. The 2023 Ducks of Year 9 is awarded to Michael Woolley. Please again congratulate our Year 9 Dedication and Merit and Ducks recipients.
To join Mr. Ledbetter and help present the Dedication and Merit and Ducks Awards for senior school students, please welcome to the stage the Dean of Senior School, Pastoral Care, Mr. David Knight, and the Head of Senior School Teaching and Learning, Mr. Andrew Newcomb.
Please hold your applause until the end. Year 10 Dedication and Merit goes to Ethan Connolly, Simeon Jeremijenko, Luca Ellero, and the 2023 Ducks of Year 10, McKinnon Moffat. And please congratulate our Year 10 Dedication Merit and Ducks recipient. Year 11 Dedication and Merit goes to Nathan Wicks, Alistair Greensill, Marco Famorca, and the 2023 Kathleen Wright Memorial Prize for Ducks of Year 11, Mitchell West and Patrick Woolley. Can we please congratulate our Year 11 Dedication Merit and Ducks recipients? Our College Ducks Approxima Accessit and Brother W.F. Spillane Memorial Prize will be announced in 2024 at the Semester 1 Academic Awards Ceremony when the ATAR results have been released. Our Year 12 Dedication and Merit goes to Cruz Bunting, Zach Lamarca, Tonga Puhela, Joshua Sefton, and at this stage, based on our internal results, our year level Ducks is Miguel Galarian. Please congratulate our Year 12 recipients.
The major awards are presented to those young men in our community who embody the finest examples of what it means to be a St. Lawrence's College gentleman. These awards recognise extraordinary participation, leadership, and excellence in all areas of college life. Announcing the major award winners is the Dean of Teaching and Learning, Dr. Liam Herbert, who will be joined by Mr. David Knight, Dean of Pastoral Care Senior School.
Mr. Woolley,
CEO of ERAA Limited, distinguished guests, staff, parents and caregivers, community members, and the wonderful students of St. Lawrence's College. 2023 has been a year of continued energy and renewal for teaching and learning at St. Lawrence's College. Indeed, our strategic intent this year, embedded within the Liberating Education Touchstone, highlights our commitment to not only strive to design programs to support our boys to achieve their personal sense of excellence, but also to contribute to the formation of the Lawrie's Gentlemen. There are a number of initiatives this year that we're extremely proud of, including the enhancement of the Certificate 2 in Active Volunteering, which is service aligned to the achievement of a certificate qualification, the strong growth in our VET programs this year, namely the Diploma of Business, very ably led by our Head of Vocational Education and Training, Mr. James McLaughlin, the implementation of the German language in middle school, our professional learning teams focused on high impact teaching strategies this year. And this was cultivated through a link with the University of Queensland Critical Thinking Project. We also implemented as a college the new version 9.0 of the Australian curriculum, one of the first schools nationally to do so. And we focused nationally on enhancing our relationships, where we hosted the National ERAA Leaders of Learning Conference. These college achievements, as well as the commitment and tenacity of our young men, once again makes me very proud to serve as your Dean of Teaching and Learning. I also wish to acknowledge our outstanding heads of faculty, our heads of study, and certainly our pastoral team, whose dedication to this school ensures that all students are encouraged to pursue their personal sense of excellence, whether that is a certificate won in construction or over 99 ATAR, all are welcomed and celebrated for those achievements. We're also very proud that we can offer multiple opportunities for our students to study a range of pathways, giving agency to students' Lawrie's journey. Indeed, one could say that it is the epitome of an authentic, liberating education. We now move to the announcement of our Year 12 major award winners. And these students are all extraordinary young men who have been selected from their peers and staff for their outstanding efforts. It gives Mr. Knight and I great pleasure to announce these award winners for 2023. And it is customary to acknowledge each award recipient as they are presented. We are grateful to invite the CEO of ERAA Limited, Mr. Chris Woolley, to join College Principal, Mr. Chris Ledbetter, to present these major awards. Could we please make Mr. Woolley feel welcome? The first two awards tonight are given to two outstanding students who are excelling in their chosen vocational pathway. And as such, I call upon Mr. James McLaughlin, Head of Vocational Education and Training, to join Mr. Ledbury and Mr. Woolley to help present these two awards. Can we please also make him feel welcome? The first award is the VET Trainee or Apprentice of the Year Award. This award is for a student whose work ethic in the workplace has been outstanding to the extent where they have been recognised by their employer as an outstanding apprentice. Tonight's winner is currently undertaking his apprenticeship as a plumber and is a very well-respected member of the St. Lawrence's College VET community. This student also delivers presentations to the junior school about VET and is considered a leader of the vocational education program. This year, the award for VET Trainee or Apprentice of the Year goes to Blake Parmenter.
The VET Student of the Year Award is presented to the student who best embraces what it means to be a vocational education student. This student leads by example at school and in the workplace. He shows initiative, teamwork, and fully participates in the vocational education program. This award recipient is an outstanding student who was also awarded the Ducks of Certificate 2 Engineering Pathways and has strong results in Certificate 2 in Electrotechnology and Certificate 1 in Construction. This student is also a strong leader of the VET program and engages regularly with the middle school students. Please congratulate the VET Student of the Year, Kaylin Cassiola.
Can we thank Mr. McLaughlin for helping to present these awards? Our next award is sponsored by the Australian Defence Force and recognises a Year 12 student who displays outstanding leadership and consistently excels in a team-based environment. This year's recipient has made an extraordinary contribution leading the college. He consistently serves the Lawrie's community through his extracurricular leadership, as well as his tenacity in task completion. This student leader is truly an outstanding Lawrie's gentleman. The Year 12 recipient of the ADF Long 10 Leadership and Teamwork Award is Mackenzie Douglas.
Our next award is the ADF Future Innovator Award. This award recognises a student who has demonstrated leadership potential, particularly in the science, technology, engineering and mathematics, or STEM field. The award sponsored by the ADF recognises recipients' science and mathematics abilities, while highlighting the value the Army, Navy and Air Force place on STEM skills and STEM career opportunities within the Defence Force. This student has led multiple initiatives this year, providing opportunities for our young boys to improve their academics by providing countless hours of his own time in the library most Wednesday and Monday afternoons to support their growth. The ADF Future Innovator Award goes to Zach Lamarca.
The Brother Brady Memorial Award for Sporting Scholar is awarded to a senior student who performs to a high standard in his studies and contributes significantly to the college sporting program and or representative sport. This year's sporting scholar is tracking very well academically. He has represented the college in first volleyball, football, and was the captain of the first basketball team. The 2023 Brother Brady Memorial Award for Sporting Scholar is awarded to Mitch Trenno.
The Geoffrey Turnbull Memorial Award for Sportsman of the Year is presented to a student who has excelled across a range of sports, including both team and individual sports. This recipient has represented the college in track and field, football, and was the captain of the cross-country team.
He also represented Australia at the World Athletics Cross Country Championships. The 2023 Sportsman of the Year is awarded to Jack Coomber.
The Edmund Rice Award for Service to the Religious Life of the College is for outstanding commitment to the liturgical and religious activities of the College. The 2023 recipient has demonstrated leadership in the liturgical life of the College over many years and has given his time freely. He is an excellent role model with a strong work ethic who always strives to do what is right. Over the years, he has represented the College in music and a variety of other activities. The Edmund Rice Award for Service to the Religious Life of the College goes to Mitchell Wilson.
The Edmund Rice Companion Award is awarded each year to a student who has made an outstanding contribution throughout their time at St. Lawrence's College by putting their faith into action through various service opportunities. The contribution of this year's recipient has been significant over a number of years. He has worked quietly behind the scenes this year and led the college with distinction through various service activities. The Edmund Rice Companion Award for outstanding contribution to Faith in Action is awarded to Sam Cancross.
The St. Lawrence's College Bursary is awarded to a student who is currently excelling in their studies and has strived to achieve these results regardless of challenges. The St. Lawrence's College Bursary is intended to support the recipient with their transition to tertiary education. The bursary is awarded to a student who has demonstrated the qualities of perseverance and dedication to excel in their studies, but who supports the ethos and values of an Edmund Rice education. The 2023 St. Lawrence's College Bursary goes to Kai Klaisenen.
The Damien Drew Memorial Award for commitment and participation recognise achievements in the holistic life of the college. This student has participated in an extensive range of co-curricular activities this year, including brotherhood, rugby, and as a gifted artist whose work was recently featured on the front cover of the Laurie's magazine, Spring Edition. This year we sought input from students as to who they thought epitomised this award. Please congratulate the Damien Drew Memorial Award winner, Tonga Paulini.
Our second last award tonight is the AMPOL All-Rounder Award, and is awarded to a student who has maintained a high standard of academic results, participated in cultural activities, and contributed significantly to the college sporting program, whilst displaying leadership qualities amongst his peers. He's truly and genuinely a Laurie's gentleman. This year's recipient is very well respected by his teachers and by his peers. Please put your hands together to congratulate the AMPOL All-Rounder Award, Ned Nowry. The Thackeray Dockery Award is sponsored by the Old Boys Association and is our final and arguably the most prestigious award this evening. And could I invite Mr. Cameron Wigan, Dean of Primary School, representing the Old Boys Association, to join Mr. Woolley and Mr. Ledbetter to assist with presenting this award. This award tonight recognises the student who embodies all that it is to be a St. Lawrence's College student. Indeed, the essence of what it means to be a Laurie's gentleman. This student is an exemplary role model who commits himself to the guiding principles of the college, including service to all areas of college life, respect, courtesy, presentation, involvement and support of others. The award is typically given to a student who is not a designated leader, but a student who leads by example with passion and faith, not because he has to, but because he wants to make a difference for others in our community. This student has been unanimously voted and endorsed by his peers to win this exceptional award. The Thackeray Dockery Award for 2023 goes to Alexander Benedict. Congratulations once again, gentlemen. Please take a seat.
Please welcome to the stage the College Vice-Captains, Knightley Patterson and Samuel Underwood, to present a vote of thanks and then lead us into singing the school song.
On behalf of the whole St. Lawrence's community, we would just like to take a quick moment to give a vote of thanks. Please hold your applause until the end. Firstly, we would like to thank the voiceover students who have made tonight possible, being Cooper Hankson and Peter Falleros, to our behind-the-scenes workers who have made tonight run smoothly, Ms. Kozlovich and Ms. Watt, to our maintenance crew for the setup and pack-up of this evening, to the heads of faculty and sport coordinators who work tirelessly to give us all opportunities we are given, to our tech staff, Mr. Williams and support, and to all the ensembles and conductors for performing the incredible pieces we saw tonight. Can you please give them a round of applause?
A
Additionally, none of this would be possible without the incredible support from our parents, caregivers, and loved ones, with many of you being present here tonight. Without your constant support, we would not be the Laurie's men we are today, and for that, we are truly grateful. Can we please give them a round of applause? Congratulations again to all award recipients and to all the Laurie's men who attended here tonight. May we all stand for the school song.
Stand for the singing of the school song. We invite Year 12 students down front for the school song.
The 2023 Secondary Awards Evening. We hope that you have enjoyed the night. The Year 12 students will now move outside. We invite all other guests to exit up the stairs and through the foyer. We wish you a good night and safe travels.